Shri Krishna tells Arjuna in Bhagavad Gita, there are many lifetimes, he had many lifetimes and Arjuna had also many lifetimes. Shri Krishna remembers those lifetimes and you don't remember, tells Arjuna. The question which was asked is, whether a master-disciple relationship also goes to many lifetimes. The same master and same disciple will take many lifetimes. In other words, who was my guru in my last lifetime? Will he be same guru in this lifetime also? So we have to understand the difference between a life of an ordinary person and a life of a jnani or avatar. All the people, those who are not realized, they take birth because of karmic relationship, because the force of karma will pull them. So it is very common that whatever your past life relationships also come in this life. Maybe it's wife, maybe it's friends, maybe it's relatives. Wherever there's a karmic impressions which are pending, to settle that karmic impressions, those relationships will be continued in the next life also. But there's a, in case of a guru and disciple relationship, there's a different situation. If guru is enlightened, then there is no question for him to take next birth. So it's not like other karmic relationships where the older relationship will get carried forward to next relationship, next life. In case of guru and shishya, if the guru is jnani, he will not have second birth, next birth. The shishya may take a birth, next birth, because of his karmic impressions are pending and he has not realized fully. So in that situation, it is not the same guru who comes in the next life. But we have to be very careful here. When we say the same guru, we are referring to the body as guru or personality as guru. Really, the personality is not guru, the Atma is the guru. So if guru is jnani, his personality is dissolved and he doesn't take another body. Then what will shishya do in the next life? It's not like another karmic relationship. He will find another guru, another person. Not the same person who was there earlier. Because that earlier person is no longer there. He has already merged with the existence. He has enlightened and is liberated. So how does a new connection happen? The new connection happens not because of the personality, but because shishya carries the vasanas and impressions of sadhana we have done with the earlier guru. Suppose somebody has done a bhakti yoga sadhana, somebody has done kriya yoga sadhana, somebody has done jnana yoga sadhana. Those vasanas will carry forward. Then he will meet a guru, maybe a jnani, maybe a kriya yoga, maybe bhakti yoga, who is related to that vasana. Now the shishya recognizes, shishya meets the guru. This relationship is not because the karmic impressions of guru carrying forward next life, the karmic impression of shishya carrying forward, vasanas of shishya carrying forward next life. He will find a guru who is matching that karmic impression. It's not the same guru as a person who came from past life. But in another way, there are not many gurus. There is only one guru. Atma is the only guru. The personality is not the guru. From that sense, the shishya recognizes the shishya meets the guru who is nothing but Atma, the self, in the form of another person. So it's not the same person who became the guru, but same Atma. Atma is all the same, appeared in a different form in this lifetime. So if the question is, the same past life guru will come in this lifetime, if the answer is no, the guru is not a person, guru is the atma. So the guru as a person, as enlightened, he is no longer there in the manifest world. But what you meet is another person, but atma appearing as another person in the form of guru. This is the relationship between the ordinary relationship carried over one lifetime to other lifetime versus a spiritual relationship carried from one lifetime to other lifetime. In the spiritual relationship, only vasanas of the shishya come, and their vasana will help him to find a guru who helps him to make progress. So then what did Krishna say to Arjuna? That there are many lifetimes for you and many lifetimes for me. I remember all of them and you don't remember. When Krishna is referring, he is not referring to himself as a person. Krishna is referring to himself as a Paramatma. There's only Paramatma, the self, which is there in any lifetime. The Atma takes many bodies. So Arjuna's karmic, because Arjuna's karmic impression, he has taken many bodies. But Krishna has no karmic impression. So when say Krishna takes many lifetimes, he relates many lifetimes as avatara. Avatara is not coming because of karmic impression. Avatara is coming because of to uphold dharma. So Sri Krishna says, as avatar, he has taken many lifetimes. Whereas Arjuna has taken many lifetimes because of his karmic impressions. So there is a difference between the birth, between the relationships which are carried forward in case of ordinary person, in case of person who are not realized, and in case of guru and shishya, and in case of avatar like Krishna. So there is a difference. This difference you have to understand.